Good morning, Staley. Today is Friday, February 5th, day being your schedule. I'm Raina Wozniak.
And I'm Casey Needham. Yesterday's birthday wishes go out to Quentin Anzalone, Ella Kuhn, Carson Evans, Haley McCaddy, and Cameron Nelson.
Today's birthday wishes go to Islama Adusalam, Grace Cordell, Brogan Donaldson, Destiny Duncan, Jay Duncan, Morgan Duncan, Nakia Mogula, Nathan Thompson, Abraham Vimbella, and our very own Matt Bryans and Bria Sisko.
Saturday birthday wishes go out to Spencer Edmondson, Eliana Arnold, Cooper Brown, Cheyenne Deal, Gabrielle Dorsal, Allie Hill, and Isabella Lampe.
Sunday's birthday wishes go to Cameron Baham, Madeline Ferris, Ryan Jabbar, and Damian Vargas. Happy birthday, everyone.
Attention all students taking the ACT this Saturday, February 6th. You need to arrive by 7:45 a.m. Check-in will be at the top of the grand staircase right inside the student entrance. You'll need a copy of your ACT admissions ticket, photo ID, plenty of number 2 pencils, no mechanical, and an ACT-approved calculator. If you do not have an ID, you will not be admitted. Please see Mr. Anderson in CR 265 if you have any questions.
It's officially Super Bowl week, so here's Sam Woody with some history of the games.
The Super Bowl is the biggest sporting event of the year. Over 100 million people watch the Super Bowl annually, and it regularly is the highest rated broadcast of the year. But how did the Super Bowl even start, and how did it grow? Here is the history of the Super Bowl. The first Super Bowl was played on January 15, 1967. The champions of the National Football League and the upstarting American Football League squared off to determine the world champion of pro football. In that first game, the Packers beat the Chiefs 35-10. 2 years later, the AFL gained more credibility after the Jets upset the heavily favored Colts in Super Bowl III. The two rival leagues merged in 1970, and since then, the winners of the American Football Conference and the National Football Conference have played for the NFL Championship. The Super Bowl is also famous for the commercials that play during breaks of the game. Many people look forward to the game only for these commercials. Some of the best ones include a Coke commercial called Hey Kid Catch, a Reebok commercial featuring an office linebacker, and a Doritos commercial called Sling Baby. The Super Bowl also has a halftime show. The first halftime shows featured marching bands. This continued until the early 1990s when the halftime show started featuring pop singers. One of these halftime shows featured Michael Jackson, which made the halftime show much more popular. The Super Bowl has had some memorable games in the past. The Steelers and Cowboys played in two close Super Bowls in the 1970s, which formed a rivalry. More recently, the helmet catch in Super Bowl 42 and a spectacular catch by Santonio Holmes in Super Bowl 43 have been memorable to fans. This is Simon Witte, signing off for STTV.
Here's N2 with the weekly sports wrap-up.
This week in Staley Sports, boys basketball defeated Oak Park 64-46 on Tuesday. Girls basketball defeated Oak Park on Tuesday and they defeated Truman 59-43 on Wednesday. Good luck to girls wrestling tonight as they compete at districts. Signing out for N2 Sports, this has been Corbin Shores and Bryce Windsor.
Check us out on Instagram, follow us on Twitter, and visit us online at stalynews.com.
And don't forget to check our YouTube channel for daily shows and more.
Have a fabulous Friday, everyone.
It messed up at the end.